Now, we could just choose a new slab style that has two layers and change the thickness. So we're going to open the slab style, so right click. We're going to create a new slab style. And in this case, we can see that this slab has just one layer. So we can add new layer, just doing right click here, click new, and slab layer. This adds a layer at the bottom of this slab, so we can just edit the thickness. We can tell this one is, for example, 17 centimeters width, and I will select the other one. I would make it just 3 centimeters thick. We can also go to attributes and, for example, change its color into another one. Let's choose this dark gray, for example. And we can call this new slab style as ramp. Now we can select these three slabs, go to properties, and change the style into the ramp. If we change the display mode, we will be able to appreciate the different colors that we have assigned to this style. Finally, if we want that, for example, the bottom part of this slab goes flat, we can make a boolean operation, a boolean subtraction. Since visual objects are blocks, we cannot use this boolean difference directly, but VisualArQ has its own commands to do boolean operations. So we're going to draw a box. We make sure that it intersects with this slab. Now we can run the subtract solid command. We select the slab, we select the solid, and the subtraction has been created. Finally, if we want to have the same 2D representation of the slab in section as we have for walls, we can just go back to the slab styles dialog, and we can assign the same hatch attributes for this second slab layer as we have for the walls. So we pick the single hatch pattern, 0.205 scale, and 45 degrees for the angle. Now, since it is not possible to assign a 2D representation of the hidden part of this slab, we will need to draw it manually. So we can just go to the level manager, we will just show everything. We make sure we are working in the ground floor, and we have the project snap on. So we will draw a rectangle from this point to this point. We can now just double click to hide the upper levels again, and we can just select this curve, maybe move it to the same layer where the slabs are. So I do right click here, change object layer, and we can just override its attributes and, for example, assign a display color like gray and align type to hidden.